Our weekend watch shines a spotlight on government activity. Cook County Board President Tony Preckwinkle says layoffs are needed to balance the 2018 budget. Earlier this week, however, a judge issued a temporary restraining order stopping the cuts of more than 150 court employees. The watchdog group, the Better Government Association, is keeping a close eye on the situation and here to talk more about the issues, the BGA's president and CEO, Andy Shy. Andy, thank you for being with us. Good morning.
Tanya, great to do this. This is the first time we've done the segment, so I'm going to begin with a present for you.
Thank you.
This is our Shining a Light on Government pen. Use it in good health as you cover the news for my alma mater, ABC7.
Thank you kindly. I'll use it in the middle of the night when I get up for the news so
there
that I can
go.
Find my way around.
Okay.
Appreciate it. Now, Chief Judge Timothy Evans is the one who filed the lawsuit in order to prevent these layoffs from happening. On what grounds did he do so?
Well, he says that, one, he can't afford the cuts because the justice system needs all the employees to move people through the courts. So on one hand, he says the cuts are unfair. On the other hand, he says that President Preckwinkle actually identified the people to be laid off, and she had no business doing that. If there's going to be cuts, he should be able to decide who goes and who stays. She argues that he refused to actually implement the cuts he was supposed to originally. He couldn't decide who to lay off. He couldn't get his unionized employees to take furlough days, so she had no choice but to make him take the cuts. And she points out that every other county office has taken the cuts and done what they had to do, and he's the only one who's refused. You know, by the way, these cuts necessitated because they repealed the pop tax, mm-hmm. and so they have a $200 million hole in the budget.
Well, what's the history here? Because there is some.
Right. Nothing's ever clean and simple in Cook County, and so Chief Judge Tim Evans was an alderman in the 4th Ward. Tony Preckwinkle beat him in an aldermanic race and became the alderman in the 4th Ward. So they've had a political feud going for the past 20-plus years. So part of this is personal. They don't get along. But part of it is a disagreement over government. And the problem here is that historically, the courts have been thought to be bloated with people and ineffective and inefficient. Judges really weren't giving us a day's work for a day's pay. And so it's hard to be sympathetic with Evans. On the other hand, if these cuts mean that people are not going to be able to get through the system in an efficient way, then we're hurting people who deserve to have justice meted out in a timely manner. Hard to make a call here. We'll probably have to let the court decide how it comes out. The cuts are only blocked temporarily at this point.
How is the county expected to give the court system more money if it doesn't have the money?
Well, that's right. They don't have more money. And in fact, Evans asked for a lot more money than he was entitled to. He has a budget for his office that's almost $40 million more than the original authorization. He asked for more because he says adult and juvenile probation and some of the services need more money to basically take care of the people who need either pre-trial or post-trial or post-conviction services. Again, critics would argue that he's had too many people for too many years and he needs to be more efficient and economize more. I think you can make the argument both ways. But at the end of the day, he's going to have to absorb some cuts like every other county office. There's no way that the court system can be immune.
And we hope for a resolution sooner rather than later.
Well, probably the next couple weeks it'll be resolved, and probably they'll split the difference in some way. He'll take some cuts, but maybe not $40 million as she initially ordered.
Appreciate your insight, Andy Shaw. Thank you so much. And you can read more BGA articles at bettergov.org. We're also posting a link on our website, abc7chicago.com.